bells tolled in the towers of Northwarden. Jubilant guards shouted from the walls, slapped backs, exchanged war stories only days old. Already a bard was milling through the crowd, gathering names and places, scribbling them down as fast as he could. Tonight they would gather and they would drink and they would play old Tomney the minstrel each time he sang their names. Listening to the general hubbub drifting in through an open shutter, Senior James allowed himself a grim smile as he dropped down to where Arutha and Locklear conferred over a battle map. By day's end, I warrant that Delacon will have died on the sword point of every man here, James said. It's a shame he hasn't really leading that raid. Indeed, Arutha agreed, his eyes shrouded as he brooded about something. I would like to ask him a few questions. I leave the High Castle for noon. Even though the Mordhall have turned from here, I'm certain that the first of them will be upon our troops there by sunup tomorrow. Fortunately, my army will be there to greet them. Still, I wish I knew what they were up to. Arutha glanced up, startled as a page boy skidded into the chamber. Your pardon, my lord, the boy stuttered. They've captured the Mordhall raiding leader. Without pause, Arutha's eyes hardened. Prepare him for questioning. Prop right now, Mordhall, and I promise you'll live to see your children become adults. Daunt me and I'll have your eyes for necklace beads and your manhood for an inkwell.
My death will be unimportant.
You think we shall torture you unto death, I would advise you to ponder my mood. Anxious though I am to have an answer, I will keep you screaming this side of death a month or a year until I feel well satisfied that we have heard all that you have to say.
A day, a month? You've already lost. Nail my entrails to your doorpost, feed my brain to your dogs, it will not matter. Even if you act now, you will be too late.
You will only win pain for your trouble. Instruct him, torturer.
You do not listen. We know the secret of Seth Anon. We shall free him.
What secret? Why to Seth Anon?
10 years ago we attacked. With Mermandamus, you captured and imprisoned him.
Deluded fool, we killed Mermandamus at Seth Anon and burnt his bones for potash. There's nothing there for Delacon to find.
A lie, we have spied. What else could you guard so closely?
How does he think he will win past our garrison at High Castle? He hasn't enough men. Answer me!
Rift machine. The six have a machine. It can take them place to place like a door between great distances. Even while your troops die at Seth Anon, we will walk through the machine. We shall be through the Dimwood and inside Seth Anon a week before you can reach us. Your troops will be exhausted. The day will be ours.
A rift machine inside the Dimwood. That bastard Surani magician's been consorting with Delacon. Torturer, tell Senior James and Locklear to ride to the Dimwood. They must find destroy that rift machine while I hide to High Castle and divert our forces once more. Time is of the essence. Howdy, folks! Welcome back! Let's play Betrayal at Krondor. Oh, man. We're back with the decidedly less overpowered group, but at least they're halfway decently equipped. I forgot I had this guy! Alright. And a bunch of loot that I can actually probably drop. Because I've been told that there's no more, like, shopping, essentially, from this point on. So I can afford to be kind of picky with what I loot. Okay. Well, the first thing I'm gonna do is save. Because I don't want to have to go through that again. Okay. So, we have to, I assume, then find this gate? Maybe? Destroy this rift machine? I would assume that is our goal. It is currently night. I think we're gonna rest until morning. That's near morning. And they were kind enough to heal me. How are we looking on food? We have rations. So, let me zoom out. I think I know where we are. Are we in... Yes, okay. So we are in the Dimwood or whatever this area is called. And I believe I left a chest full of stuff here. But I don't remember where! Ha ha! I know it's in, like, at the base of a mountain somewhere. And I'm fairly sure it's not on this side. So let's... Let's just get in on here. We charge forward and catch the enemy off guard. I can appreciate that. Oh, and they have a caster. Get in there, James. I missed having melees with decent move speeds. However, these guys are not freaking Gorath. No! Oh, that was beautiful. Thank you for killing your companion for me. You made my job a lot easier. Oh, you're not gonna be going anywhere, buddy. Oh, I had forgotten the two terabad melees over here. Okay, well that was pretty painless, which pleases me. I don't even know, like, I don't even think we need money. So I really don't need to be looting a whole heck of a lot. I'm gonna take rations, especially non-poisoned ones, because I don't know that we have access to a shop. I can't remember if this... that may be a shop right over there. But that doesn't necessarily mean that they sell rations. Alright, we already have a bunch of herbal packs, so we're gonna leave that. Let's go and see if this guy's even open. Tavern was locked tight. The sign says this place is called the Fife and Laurel, said James. A man in dark colored clothes suddenly appeared behind them. The Fife and Laurel is closed, he hissed. It's been closed since the destruction of Sethanon. If you are looking for something to eat, there's good trapping to the southeast. Before they could say another word, the man had slipped away. Okay. Wrong button. I want my map. So, okay, I'm facing north. I want to see where I am relative to everything. I think I left the stuff, like, on this side of the river. So we're going to have to figure that out. I wish that they give you, like, an overview map of the areas. So I could have, you know, some idea of where a bridge might be. Oh, we have Rusulki. Ah, I was gonna say, like, we'll avoid that because I don't think we necessarily need to fight it. But it apparently had a different idea. I think these things are a spell, so I wanna get my melees up front. Look at the grid here. I really appreciate, like, that they do this. Like, that I can't just walk out into the water. Get a James. James, you're terrible and I hate you. Wait, that wasn't... No, that was James. For some reason, for a second there, I thought it was Locklear. I don't know. Hey, and down she goes. Okay. Hole's not big enough. Ooh, what do we got? River Song. Sure. What does it do? Spells. I think this lets you summon a Rusulki, if I had to guess. Summons a Rusulka who will fight with you until the combat is over. Only 4 per combat are allowed. Still, might be worthwhile. I don't know if it actually will be worthwhile, but I'm not gonna complain. Oh. 27 coins, sure. Why not? Oh, have I found you guys? Are you... I was gonna say, well, I'm gonna need to cast my spell that lets me actually read this. Alright, let's see how badly we fail. I don't remember whether or not we've gotten into these or not. Bloodless and boneless, it travels about, yet it never leaves home. Is it a wheel? No. I think we've done these, first off. Secondarily, I have no idea what this is. Bloodless. Oh, it's a snail. Yeah, wow. Alright. Okay, we got some flame root oil, which I'm not gonna bother with. You hear it speak, for it has a hard tongue, but it cannot breathe, for it has not a lung. Again. Again, I have no idea. It's a bell. Okay, maybe we haven't done these. I'm thinking I'm probably wrong when I said that we did. Yeah, we haven't done these. I'm gonna take this ruby just in case. Adventuring tax and all that. You seek it out when your hunger's ripe. It sits on four legs and it smokes a pipe. Be a stove, perhaps. Look at that. I got one. That's all I ask. Because, you know, if you're going to throw me a stack of these things, I can at least get one of them. Night fingers. I think we already have that. Yep. And the last one. Has a tongue but never talks, has no legs but sometimes walks. Is that a shoe? Alright, I'll take it. 50-50. 2 for 4. And we have a freaking glory hand in here because K. And this is poison. Yeah, okay. I don't think I'm gonna take any of that. And it looks like this chunk of the map, yep, is a dead end. Alright, so we apparently do not want to follow the river west. And instead want to go east. Well, let's have a nap. We have enough rations here to get us through a fair amount of time, so long as I'm not, like, sleeping. Oh yeah, there's the bridge right over there. Ha ha! How novel. If only I'd turned left instead of right. Patris was beginning to look pale. James felt a little guilty for having dragged the magical advisor along on such an extended mission, but since he had no knowledge whatsoever of magic, Prince Arutha has thought it wise to at least have him take a look at the alien rift machine. What none of them had counted on was that they would have been making much of their journey on foot. For days they had ridden at a panicked pace, astride three of the finest chargers lent from the stables at Northwarden. Driven too hard for too long, the horses had all died within hours of one another, expiring long before they had reached the outer rim of the Dimwood Forest. From there, they had been forced to walk, sneaking past a patrol of goblins who were taking up a defensive position on the road leading north out of the Dimwood. Now, far behind enemy positions and without quick transport, they had a very difficult task ahead of them. So, nothing much to accomplish. Find something the size of a man in the hole of the Dimwood shouldn't be too difficult. Not the most difficult thing Aruth has ever had us do. Remember that berry hunt we went on after the Riftwar? Very nearly wouldn't have found them if we hadn't realized the rainfall had been heavier that year. I'm just sorry we had to drag poor old Patris along on this one. You worry about your own skins, you whelps. I can get run with the best of them, and you two ain't no exception. Get runny-nosed on me, and I'll brain the both of you. I love this dude! He's probably one of my favorite characters in this game. Like the freaking snarky old man. Better listen to him, Jimmy. He's a killer. Uh-huh, I believe you're right. So, where do you think we should start looking for this rift machine? Your guess would be as good as mine. Well, since we just came from the north, I'd say it's a good bet it isn't up there anywhere. That still leaves east, west, south, and everything in between, like spearing fish in a barrel. All that being the case, I suppose we just try and be as systematic as possible. I say we make a sweep east, then maybe move to the south or west. East. West seems as good a direction. Not sure, but the instinct that's telling me east is the one that's kept me alive all this long. I've learned not to ignore it. If you've got a better idea, I'll follow your lead. I mean, I don't really care. I just want to find this chest where I left, like, a staff of death magic and some spells. That's my goal here. And it's going to be even harder because I don't have Gorath's freaking wonder spyglass. I'm pretty sure it's not this one. Yeah, open it. Nope. Oh, no. I'm just going to have to keep my eyes peeled. I'm pretty sure I didn't leave it in a stump either. Oh, hey. Oh, shit. Seriously? A bunch of good rations. All right, we'll share them out. How's everybody looking? 9, 14, 14, 14, 9, 14. I will give you 5. Give you 5. So now everybody should have 2 stacks. Yes. All right, so we're good on food then. Holy shit. Is this the game, like, throwing the player a bone if you elected to, you know, not stock up beforehand because you didn't know that you were going to be trapped here with no access to shops? Probably a good thing. Random chest. Oh god. Oh, seriously, Union wore off? Well, we did sleep, alright. Fair. I'll give it to him. Okay. Inside a burning house, this thing is best to make, and best to make it quickly before the fire is too much to take. Is it haste? Haha, because you make haste to escape a burning house. Okay, got some poison cure. I'll take that, as well as some poison. Not too worried about poisoning weapons, but I will take any extra berries that they want to give me. So now I'm 3 for 5. Is that a cat? The animal is dead. Peeled back the carcass and another 3 rations. Which we really do not need. Yet. Give it time. Just watch. I'm gonna turn this chapter into like 30 hours of Wilderness Simulator in Betrayal at Krondor. I'm just curious how many days it's gonna be before we finally start eating Patris. He's old and frail, so he's gonna be the first one to go. Naturally. Okay, I wanna rest because it's getting dark out, and apparently Patris, well yeah, because he's casting Union. Patris was injured. Oh. Oh, and I need to cast you. It'd be nice if from that screen they gave you the ability, like, hey, you're an idiot. Do you want to cast a Union spell so you can read this without having to back out and everything? Pounds all day, beats all night, never rests. I'd say your heart, but that's not enough letters. Pounds all day. And the sun pounds on you and then beats on the rest of the... Is it wind? No. Oh, it's a wave. It is not waves. Oh, really? I have no idea. This is a good riddle. Pounds all day. Oh, it's... I was on the right train of third. I just went the wrong way with it. It's the surf. Okay. Rations? Bunch of rations, healing supplies. I will take the berries. I do not want 2 stacks of them, however. Let's see, actually, I mean, I could afford to take 2 stacks of them, I guess. Wow, they are just throwing stuff at me. It's like they expected me to come in here with, like, absolutely no preparation, which is probably smart, because that's probably what I would have done if people weren't telling me, like, hey, you need to be ready for these next couple chapters, because shit's gonna get... Okay, seriously, I opened 1 chest, and they're like, hey, guess what? You need to cast Union again. Patris hasn't even had a chance to heal from the last casting. All across the countryside to front doors he travels, but you never invite him in. No idea. Man, for every one I get right, I get like 3 wrong. A path. Ha ha! I'm just... Just not there, guys. One day I'll... I've apparently already been in this chest. Dang it. So not only am I made to look a fool, but I'm made to look a fool for a second time! They were not alone. Patris' pulse quickened as he saw a lone figure approach, but when it became apparent they were not being attacked, he relaxed a bit, squinting slightly in an attempt to see who was about to join them.
I was wondering where you two were.
Seriously? Duke Martin's out here? James Locklear, what are you doing here? Prince Arutha told us that a Surani magician had given over a rift machine to the Mord Hall for use in this battle. You've come down here to locate and destroy it before Delacan can get full use of it. How did you get here? We never saw you at the castle. When a portion of the Southern Arrow Company began to fall back from Northward, and I decided to follow after them and make sure they weren't up to any mischief. As you might have guessed, they had that infernal machine of theirs set up a few miles to the north, but they spotted me and assumed I was a human mercenary that was slacking behind. So you played along and went through the gate and ended up here. Well, how did you know you wouldn't end up in Sarsargoth? I didn't, but I was surrounded by Mordhall. I imagine my best hope for survival lay on the other side of wherever that door led. Whenever we emerged here, I told the captain that I had to rejoin my unit and I was off. There were a few close moments along the way, but I won for it last. Why didn't you try to destroy it? I thought about it, but the device was surrounded by Mordhall at the time, so I decided I'd try to gather some help. You three are the first humans I've seen in a week. Relative to where we are now, where is the Rift machine? Is it nearby? I'm not sure. To escape the Mordhall camp, I slipped under a stack of canvas bags on the back of a supply wagon they brought with them. After we had traveled for a few hours, they pulled over for a nature break, and I was able to get away. I do recall hearing water as they were moving out, however. So you were near a waterfall or a river. Well, at least that gives us an idea of where we can start our search. Anything else we should know? From listening to the wagon driver's talk, I get the feeling I wasn't the only unexpected visitor through the machine of theirs. Apparently some rebel Mordhall chieftain came through and caused them a good deal of grief, then headed south towards where one of their warlords is staging for the attack on Sethanon. They were none too happy about him being on the loose. I'm hoping I can find him myself so I can ask him a few questions. Any idea who the warlord in the south is? I believe it's Delacon's son, Morolf, though I couldn't be certain of it. They were bandying about names so fast, I was having a little trouble understanding all of it. My Mordhall isn't all it used to be. So, he says it sounds like it's near a river, well, or like a river or a waterfall. And I mean, we saw that waterfall to the west of where we started. And that was where the Rusulka was? So, we've explored that. But there might be other waterfalls, firstly, and secondly, we've only been on one side of the river, and I believe we can get to the other side. So, we've got some ground to cover, if I had to guess. What is it with Sethanon in the Mordhall? This is the second time they've attacked there, and I never understood why they struck 10 years ago. There's nothing in Sethanon but a heap of runes. At least the last time we had an army to get in their way. Even at a forced march, Prince Arutha's men can't get here for another few days, and they'll be exhausted once they arrive, and... Well, now that I think of it, why is Delacon bringing an army? If he expected to arrive at Sethanon behind our lines, he could simply walk in, take what he wants, then turn around and walk through the Rift Gate without a scratch, unless he expected someone else to be there. Who does he think will be at Sethanon? What does it mean? It means they didn't get what they came for the last time they raided. Also means Delacon has been watching Sethanon for quite some time, possibly as long as the end of the last battle. You know, Squire Phillips' men will be in the way. Squire Phillips' men? What would a squire be doing leading a counterattack? It won't take me too long to explain it to you at the moment. Suffice it to say, I don't think Delacon and his men will be having a good day once they get to Sethanon. If we're lucky, they will be deterred long enough for Arutha to start nibbling away their flanks. One major advantage I can see in our favor is that we in the Mordhall are at equal disadvantage. Neither of us will have a clear supply of materials, and they will have to hold some of theirs out so they can retreat to the Northlands when the time comes. They intend on retreating. I didn't seem to be too interested in it the last time they came. A bit of advice, though. If you come across any food, I'd suggest holding on to it. We found several of their food caches and poisoned them as we did at North Warden, and with two armies marching through here at the same time, I imagine food is about to get scarce. As unpleasant an option as it may seem, you may have to resort to taking food off of the dead. Alright. Well, hey, you know, we got some information. I'm gonna go ahead and save again. And we now know that this thing is near a waterfall of some sort. So let's poke around a little bit further. Have a look at my map. Oh. Again, I'm trying to remember where... this dang chest, ow, as we bump into an enemy patrol. Ow. Alright, couple Quesians and a couple Mordhall. This is like non-issue. Gonna get you right here. Oh, that was convenient. No, put it down, you jerk. Oh, seriously? You dicks? Gotta go for Pantris? Well, guess what? Pappy's got a spark thrower. lightning-based death is going to be quite commonplace here. Let's see here. Get in there, James. No Gorath. No Gorath. Patrice is actually hurting quite badly, I notice. He's got like 29 health left. Thankfully, he has a Staff of Thunder and Lightning. James can't hit anything. Oh, I did not miss James at all. He's freaking terrible. All right, Patrice. I mean, we got a shed load of these, so I'm gonna start drinking them. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. So we'll heal Patrice up. Throw some lightning. Patrice is scoring all the kills. James! Oh my god. Oh my god, these melees, you guys. Ugh. Where do you think you're going, buddy? I know the revelation that Patrice can call down lightning bolts is probably shocking to some. But you gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, high quality ruby. I'm gonna take gems and stuff because paranoia. But aside from that, can't imagine there's a lot that's really worth much. Can I loot? Can I get him? Nope, nothing. All right. Okay. Well, I mean, I guess, oh, there's another bridge. I think that's a bridge right there. No, that's a tree. Okay, I was like, is that a scorpion over there? It's hard to tell. Scorpions just kind of look like grayish brown lumps in this, so it's kind of hard. Ooh. An herbal pouch. Nah, I think we're good. Go ahead and rest. Good job, guys. I should have just had them rest until morning and dealt with the fact that they're going to be a little bit injured. Oh, well. Food for thought, I guess. A body. Take those coins. We're sitting at 2007 royals, which I'm thankful for. Sure, why not? A little bit of healing never hurt anybody. And a bowstring and stuff. Nothing too interesting there, and nothing there. All right. I know I just saw a bridge. Yeah. All right. So where am I? Oh, I saw it just as I flipped it in my. Yeah, he's like a freaking legion, just sitting out here like. So you guys want to cross, huh? I imagine we have to go this way though. I'm gonna save and we'll give it a go. So long as I can keep Patrice casting spells, like we can cast Evil Seek. Alright, I think it was just a bunch of goblins, right? Yeah. Alright, let's get in here. Oh, hey. The bridge is heavily guarded. Several goblins eye them suspiciously as they approach. Delicon has sent us to help guard the rift machine, shouted James in a gruff voice. One of the goblins turned to the others, and James thought he heard the words Queegean mercenaries. This was followed by some laughter, which had died down almost as quickly as it began. What's the password? Demanded a goblin. Okay, so my question now is, can I actually bluff them? And if I fail, I'm probably going to get into a fight. But if I get into a fight and I kill them, are we just going to, like, be stuck here? Or am I going to... We'll try bluffing them. James looked confident. Delicon gave us a special password himself, he said. I hope you're familiar with it. I'd hate to be in your hides if you're not. The new password is Seth Anon. The goblin considered this for a moment, then shouted, It's a very bad day for liars! Prepare to die, kingdom dogs! Alright, there's like, I think like six of them? I think we can probably kill, well... Alright, yeah, there's six of them. I would say, if we could keep them away from Patrice... I would say we could probably kill six goblins. Keeping them away from Patrice, however... Holy shit, they've got fire arrows! Okay, I have an idea. Because I'm sure one's gonna follow him down here. Oh no, not really, actually. Okay. They're just like kind of fluttering all over. So I need to keep this space clean. But what my goal is going to be is to kill this dude and then like shift my entire group over a square so that Patrice is in a corner. Or I guess if we kill this dude, we only have to worry about this one. Kill this guy, James. Thank you. Locklear, I don't suppose you'd be willing to murder this fella, would ya? Hey, look at that. All right. Where is it? Evil Seek. And we are gonna see that 21. Yeah, we're gonna cook some major damage out here. Seriously? Why can he not? Why can he not? Oh my god, alright. So apparently we're not gonna be able to do a fun thing, because why would I be able to do that? In that case... an earthquake trap. Grief 1000, I had to spare thy eyes. Man, I forgot that Patrice has, like, no fun. Here, let's do River Song. Let's summon a Rusalki. That was very little fanfare, but okay. It is just not the day for crossbowmen today. Yeah, look at that. Throwing a little bit of death magic. Alright, Patrice, you just sit there and rest. And, I mean, I can summon more of them, too, if I really want to, which is kind of cool. I don't know how globally useful it's gonna be, but it's kinda... Locklear, I think, is poisoned. Is Locklear poisoned? Locklear is, in fact, poisoned. I caught that shit, game! Nope. Nope. Give him one. Okay. I'm gonna have him cured on his next turn. Ah, you jerks. Alright, Locklear, use the berries. And, drink some healing. Okay. And I'm gonna nuke that dude. Actually, here, we'll just use our staff for it. Why not? I've got staffs, and I think I have another one waiting in the wings, so... I'm not worried about actually using consumables at this point. Oh, you jerk. Oh, freaking Rusalka coming in clutch. I'm gonna move James over here, or Locklear over here, just in case. Just in case that thing, like, misfires with that and, like, melts half my party. Alright, so can I cross the bridge? I can! That's great! I'm incredibly pleased that they're gonna let me just, like, go across now. Hey, bodies, how you doing? Man, everything's poisoned! Is anybody else poisoned, just to make sure? No, alright. Wait. Even their armor is coated in poison. I don't even know. Poison rations. Yo, dog, let's coat our armor in poison just in case the enemy attempts to gnaw on us. Got a key. And Kaltari poison. And a grief maker, which I do not believe is as good as anything we are using. No, all right. Okay, well, I think, are we on the other side of this thing now? No, I don't believe we are. I don't know. We might be. No, we're not. Okay, we came from the north. Like, mentally mapping this shit out here is kind of complicated when it jumps you, like, from area to area during fights like that. However, we are at 35 minutes, so I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it an episode here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. Hope you had a good time, and I will see you next time, when the adventure continues. Until then.